So I haven't done a favorites video in a while, and I figured I would do one for the month of August because I am making videos every day in September across my three channels, my main channel, my second channel, and this channel, and I figured it was time to give the beauty channel a little love. So let's get started. The first product I've been loving this month is the Meet Matte palette. This is a palette from The Balm. I've seen it a lot in Michelle Phan's videos. She's been using it in different ways, like either as eyeshadow or as like nose contouring, whatever. And I've been lusting after it for a while, but it's usually about like $36 retail, and that is a lot. So I saw this palette on hotlook.com, which is basically my life. I check it every day. I don't always buy something, but they have really good sales. Anyway, they had a sale on The Balm products, and they had this palette for $18, which is like half price of what it usually is, and I figured now is the time, if ever, to do it. So it comes with a whole range of matte shades and a pretty good size of them too. I usually use the kind of lighter and brown shades and a little bit of this matte Patel. I like it a lot, and all the colors are named after different mattes, and this one is Matt Smith. Yeah. Yeah, Doctor Who. Kind of a nerd. Sorry about it. Next, I have this Dream Fresh BB Cream from Maybelline. I like this a lot. I like it a lot more than the Garnier BB Cream that I had. This is an 8-in-1, and it is sunscreen. That is definitely a plus from the Garnier one, because that one did not have SPF as far as I could tell. And this is really good. My color is probably the lightest one that there is, but I've been using this pretty much every day. So yeah, good up on you, Maybelline. It's also not as greasy than some other BB creams, which is really good in the summer when I'm already sweaty. I don't want to feel any more greasy, so this is a good thing. Then next, the text has completely rubbed off on this, but it is the Maybelline Dream Lumi Touche Touch, something like that, concealer. It's a highlighting concealer, so it's really good for under eyes. Yeah, this replaced my Soap and Glory Kick-Ass concealer, which was like two different shades of concealer in one thing, which was really good, except the packaging completely fell apart. But this is actually a little bit better. I like this more liquidy formula. That one was a little bit thick for my liking. This is a lot easier to blend in. So yeah, I like this a lot. When I was in London, I realized that the magazines give away beauty products sometimes. Like when you buy the magazine, you get a little beauty product or a pair of sunglasses or something with it, which is not something you usually see in the States. And I think that's really cool. So I bought a copy of Glamour just to get a trial size of the Benefit Bad Gal Lash. And I really like it. It kind of gives me the length and drama that I like on my eyelashes. And I'm gonna have to throw it out soon though, because I've had it for about 3 months and I think that's the shelf life of mascara. I don't really know. If it's not, you can tell me in the comments. I'm sure you will be happy to correct me. I might repurchase this again. I usually don't go for actually buying higher end mascaras because I just, for the shelf life, I don't think it's really worth it. But I've been enjoying this little trial size so far. It's also very good for traveling. Next, which I've absolutely fallen in love with, I would marry it if that were legal or, you know, beneficial to my health, is the Revlon Just Spit and Kissable Balm Stains. They're awesome. The color stays on for a while. They feel amazing. They're very buildable. I just love it. Here, let me swatch it for you. That's nice, isn't it? In it? It's real nice. This is the color Romantic. I also have Sweetheart, but I don't know where it is. That's a really bright pink. I think I was wearing it in my last video. Yeah, this is a good thing. Like it a lot. Also on the lip product end, I have the Kate Moss lipsticks from Rimmel. I like these a lot. I had another one of these in like a nude shade, and they're just so creamy and nice and just a really cool range of colors. So I picked up two more in the last couple weeks. This one is from the fall collection. It's number 11. It's a very dark red. I will swatch it for you. It comes out a lot brighter on here. I don't know. I get like a different shade when I swatch it, and then a different shade in the tube, and then a different shade on here. It's just not very consistent, but either way, I'm happy with it, and it smells really good too. And then I have this number 12, which is a really bright orange. That is how you do numbers, Charlotte. That's very bright, but you know, I walk on the wild side. And then finally, I've gotten into doing my brows. I never thought that I had to before, because I have really naturally thick brows, but I've been into filling them in a little bit more just to kind of define my face a little bit. And so I got the Urban Decay Brow Kit in Brown Sugar, which is the darker of the two kits. I don't know if there are any more, but I don't know. There was one that was more for like blonde hair and one that was more for brown hair, so I went with the one that matches me a little bit more. And then my camera died, so I couldn't properly finish the video, but I hope you liked it otherwise, and I will see you at other times this month. Goodbye.